Good evening, I'm Janelle Stelson.
And I'm Ron Martin. Our top story tonight, this might look like a fancy bar at a nice restaurant, but it's actually the inside of a state office building in Harrisburg. And here, you're paying for state employees to taste wine.
And on your side, government reporter Matt Belanger shows us why it is happening and why some say it needs to change in tonight's top story.
The sign on the wall identifies it as the Board Tasting Room, a space created in 2007 inside the Pennsylvania Liquor Control Board's office building in Harrisburg at a cost of about $35,000, complete with adjustable lighting, big screen TVs, leather furniture, and a stocked bar. Among other uses, about once a week, you'll find a team of nine experts in this room tasting sample bottles of wines and other products kept in an adjoining closet, deciding what could eventually end up in Pennsylvania's 620 state-run wine and spirit stores.
It's a waste of money, and it's just another sign that the PLCB has to go.
Jay Ostrich is with the Commonwealth Foundation, a group that's been pushing for state lawmakers to dissolve the PLCB and allow private businesses that buy licenses to sell wine and liquor to the public.
At a time when Pennsylvania families' budgets are stretched thin, we do not need a group of state workers stretched out in a wine shrine trying to educate our palates.
Anybody who would criticize that, that certainly would be an uninformed opinion, if you will.
Joe Conte is the CEO of the Pennsylvania Liquor Control Board. He says the tastings and a controlled environment in which to conduct them are necessary for the PLCB to conduct business in the alcohol industry. He calls the room's $35,000 price tag a bargain, pointing out most of the work, like building these cabinets, was done by the PLCB's own maintenance workers.
So this is what we do here. This is what people do in the private sector in other states. And it's very important that we ensure that it's a very safe and acceptable product for our consumers here in Pennsylvania.
So is the room over the top?
The room is certainly not over the top. It's a multi-purpose room. It's being used for all kinds of activities by executives and all kinds of people in this room. So it is certainly not over the top. And the characterization of that room is really the only thing that's over the top.
It's actually offensive to say that you're being economical while being wasteful at the same time.
Ostrich says the state-funded space is an example of why the PLCB is out of date.
Consumers can educate their palate for themselves. They don't need a team of taxpayer-paid employees with pensions and benefits that we can no longer sustain. They need to choose their booze for themselves.
You know, those state-employed experts who do the tasting make between $40,000 and $60,000 a year, in case you were wondering, and they also do have other duties. And by the way, those tastings usually happen in the morning hours, and tasters don't actually swallow the product.